Doesn't even intelligence require experiences from the past, or does intelligence operate in a vacuum? No, it does not. Obviously, it does not. You see, even right now, let's take this example. Even right now, we are using a particular language which is coming from the past, right? But what is happening right now is beyond language. Every single word that we are using is coming from the dictionary. But what is happening right now is beyond the dictionary. Now, let's look at this camera. The same waves are falling upon this camera as are falling upon your retina and your ears, right? In fact, it is gathering all the information more diligently than you ever can. You are gathering something and leaving out something. This camera is gathering everything. And all that comes from the past, remember. Sounds, sights, all that is a product of the past. This body is a product of the past, and all that it is recording is this body. All that it is hearing is words that are anyway contained in the dictionary, all in the past. But there is something happening there in you which simply cannot happen here. That is intelligence. That is intelligence. It keeps on getting what I say, it keeps on recording what I say, but it never gets anything. Really gets anything. The same words that your ears are receiving, this too is receiving. But something is happening there which cannot happen here. That is what is intelligence. That is intelligence. And if that is not happening there, then the fellow is as good or as dead as this camera. Purely mechanical. Are you getting it now? So yes, words will come from the past, but what is happening right now is beyond words. Had it been just words, then this camera would have been a very wise man by now. Because it takes all the words in. It keeps accumulating all the words. 100 GB of words and sights. Yet it never gains anything. 100 GB and no gain. No understanding.
In our life, we have cleared JE, people around us say that we are doing well. So, at this point, why we need to understand these things?
Suman, how do you know you have done well?
I'm not telling people around us. Tell us.
Right. Do you don't even know that you have done well? Somebody else is coming and telling you have done well. That's the entire point. That you are so dependent upon space. Other people are space. Other people are space. You are so dependent upon that other that you don't exist. Because only intelligence exists. Others come and give you a certificate, you feel I must have done something good in life. Others come and tell you are brilliant, you start feeling I am brilliant. And that would mean that Suman is always afraid. Do you see why? Because if people can tell him he is brilliant, the people can also tell him that he is stupid. And then he'll have to believe that as well. You can't be selective in your beliefs. Can you be? If you have opened the gates for compliments to come in, you have also opened the same gate for abuses to come in. When someone, see, how do you know, Suman, that you are successful? Someone comes and says, Suman, you are successful. And Suman translates that into, I am successful. And hence, you are bound to be insecure. Do you see this? We said the brain is forever afraid. Do you see why? Because the brain has no intelligence. It depends completely on experiences. Whatsoever is happening to it, it just keeps taking in and also identifies with what is happening. So someone else comes and says, here, this is your religion. And someone starts saying, I am a Hindu, I am a Hindu, I am a Hindu. Now, how are you a Hindu? Time gave it to you. And hence, your religion has no strength, no conviction behind it. You never chose your religion, did you? It was not coming out of your free will. And whatsoever will not come out of your free will, of your own intelligence, will have no energy, no power, no response behind it. It will be a dead affair, completely dead affair. So that is the reason why you are so insecure, most of us, about others. Whatsoever we may be doing, we are always looking over our shoulders. What are the others saying about us? What are the others saying about us? We depend upon some other fellow. You know, even right now, you feel elated that you are an IITian. But your being an IITian is so very dependent upon that other who certified that you have cleared the JEE, right? What if that other had made a mistake? And that happens. In any process, errors are there. Errors are a part and parcel of any process. What if your paper had been incorrectly checked? What if there was some kind of computational error or anything else? Then all your self-esteem would have been totally lost. Because you depend so much on space and time. And you rely on all your past laurels. Class 10th percentage, class 12th percentage. That's what keeps you inflated, afloat. You take that away and you collapse. Take the badge of IIT away from an IITian and he collapses. Because intelligence is not in operation. Because you are so dependent upon experiences, the external. Do you see that all experiences come from outside? They are external. And to be dependent on your experiences, which is to be brain driven, is to be a slave, really a slave. And a slave never enjoys anything. A slave is perpetually afraid. In a slave's life, there is no real freedom. He is always looking at his masters. What to do next? What is the real trend? If you tell me this, I'll do this. You understand this?